Many German politicians expect the next president to ask for more German troops for Afghanistan, including combat troops for the south. Mm-hmm. Do you think the next president will get enough support?
The next US president will get some additional support in Afghanistan. How much is enough is a difficult question. I would expect that on the question of troops, of combat troops, of more Europeans that are in the fight in the south, that is going to be difficult. If one says money, police, some troops, additional efforts across the board, then I do think that Europeans probably will step up to the plate, and that will help Obama or McCain say to the American people, our efforts abroad are now being advanced by the fact that our friends are now more willing to be by our side.
You said that it is a fairly safe bet that Obama will be the next president of the United States. What do you think will be his priorities for cooperation with Europe?
In the first instance, the priority will be to put the relationship on a more solid footing. And that will mean clear statements about the need for a renewal of the transatlantic relationship, but not just a renewal, a relationship that is more balanced, in which the two sides are listening to each other more than they have been in the past. And I also think that the Obama administration will go out of its way to do things to win back European support, including major new initiative on global warming, closing Guantanamo, making sure that other issues with respect to the treatment of detainees are addressed. In other words, it will not just be Obama asking the Europeans to do things, it will be adjustments in U.S. policy in directions that Europeans will find more favorable.
What are Senator Obama's closest foreign policy advisors?
Most of them are people that served in the Clinton administration, so I think you can expect an ideology, an approach that looks quite similar to that adopted during the Clinton era, with obvious adjustments and amendments based upon the fact that we live in a new world, that we're heading toward some kind of multipolar structure, that we live in a world of Islamic extremism, the threat of terrorism. So it is, I think, a liberal internationalist agenda, but one that is updated to current circumstances. One of the lessons the United States learned during the Bush administration is that it still has in Europe its best partner. So I think it will continue to work closely with the Europeans on all different fronts, but it will also address, obviously, the Middle East, Northeast Asia, and other parts of the world where there are more pressing threats. So, to some extent, Europe matters less to the United States as a strategic theater, because it's now focused on other parts of the world, but Europe matters more as a potential partner, because I think the U.S. has realized that it needs European help on many, many different international issues.